Hello, and welcome to the non-Greg Sterlis, Greg Sterlis show, Sterling. Except only the substitutes. Thomas I'm your Sterling. Host, the Pamazon. And I'm in my workout gear, and probably have makeup all over my face. Sorry, not sorry. It's the co-host, John.
It looks fine now. Tiny Tim, I'm sure his makeup looked bad sometimes. Well, probably not.
Oh, the dots!
Hey,
it's the dots!
I is here.
Great. Yes, yes. It is a wonderful show.
So if we have a wide shot here, I don't know if we can see the monster on the floor. Oh, we cannot. Okay, well, we lost our great space alien mascot, Leonardo.
This ain't Pep's first time on the show he's been on.
I know, we haven't really said anything about it. So this is lovely Pep is on the floor here sleeping. You can't see him. He was not meant to be a replacement for Leonardo, but we brought him home, and Leonardo was like,
he sniffed him hardly, and next thing you know.
And Leonardo loved puppies. Loved them. So we still have the lovely Penelope, though.
Yes, we have Penelope, but you can never replace Leonardo. It's very sad.
Pepe's, it's very, very sad. There we go. We're going to see him.
Pepe's a nice little dog, but...
He's pretty good. Sometimes he gets a little squawky, but he's pretty good.
Yes,
And he's well-behaved. He doesn't poop on the floor, even though he's a little dog. And they're known for pooping and peeing all over everything. It's like he's not done that once.
Well, he did once, but that was our...
Because you didn't take him out.
I was being pokey, and...
Please take me out. I've got to pee.
That's the Pepe. That's Pepe Elliot. Elliot Pepe.
There he is.
But for the most part, he doesn't pee. He's just a very tired little dog right now from having a bit of a psychotic freak out. He had a panic attack there or something. I don't know. He was very terrified of somebody Dudley knows. But he's calmed down.
I'm sending a message to my friend about a delightful TV show called Dr. Snuggles. If you've never seen it, it's a wonderful kids show from the Netherlands, and
it is very fun.
It's awesomely fun and ridiculous and super psychedelic and very strange. It's very fun. It's on the YouTubes if you're.
It is on the tubes.
It's on the tubes.
Other good public access shows besides this one though is. Oddville TV is great.
If you've never seen TV?
That's a really great show. And then, of course, there's the Coco Crystal show.
Are these local?
They're all in, I think, in New York at least.
Oh, okay.
And then there's, what's the one? Crazy something. Crazy Can or something. I forget. Anyway, that's a really fun one. But I mostly like the Coco Crystal show and Oddville TV. Oddville TV ran for a long time, since the 80s, and then it eventually moved to MTV, and then it went back to public access.
Ah, okay.
It became Oddville MTV when it was on MTV, but then it went back to public access, and it's Odd TV again.
Well, there's probably more freedom on the access that is public.
It's true. Oh, we're getting more,
Doggy cam.
Dog cams.
Dog cam.
But,
I know it's not showing up yet, but it will. Don't you worry, gentle viewer. Yeah, so we're very sad to lose our...
Yes, we miss Leonardo.
So much. He was...
It's true.
Such a crazy, noisy freak. Jumping all over. Always slept with me.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just not the...
It's not the same.
Not the same without...
Oh, here we go. There it is. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Of course he moves.
Of course he moves. He's going to itch something. He's going to get back down with those big brown eyes.
Oh, little root beer eyed dog.
Root beer, I love root beer.
I do too.
It's so delicious.
I do like root beer. I like, one time I had this pink root beer. It was the tastiest root beer I ever had.
Pink? Sounds like sacrilegious.
Well, that's because when I asked the guy, they said that's what it naturally is like if you don't add food coloring.
Oh, really? It's pink?
Yeah, it was like really pink.
Huh, that's interesting.
It was really tasty though. I love root beer. I don't really like that much soda, but I love root beer.
I like the root flavored things.
I like birch beer as well.
birch beer, root beer,
sarsaparilla.
Ginger beer, sarsaparilla.
Ginger beer is so good.
All that stuff. I even like licorice.
Oh, licorice is the best.
I know a lot of people hate licorice, but I love the licorices.
Don't ask because they're boring.
No kid, they're no puppy. Lay back down.
I know, pup. Go
I got
here.
The itches right now.
Or pupper.
But lay back yeah. down. Say hi to the people.
I know, pup.
No, okay, now I just moved away.
Whatever, pup.
All right, fine. Be that way. He's being very uncooperative. Or maybe he'll jump up and people can see him.
Yes. Yes, this is...
Yeah, we had hoped that Leonardo would play with him, because Leonardo loves dogs, and when he did, I knew something was...
That was very sad, very upsetting. Yes. They only interacted, like, once. Pepe sniffed him, Leonardo sniffed him, and then Leonardo laid down, and...
And then I was like, oh, crap, like, okay. Something's wrong with Leonardo.
They only were in the house together one day. Yep. It was very sad.
But, there you go. He's on your lap.
Yes, now the people can
his
see
his favorite
him.
Place.
Yes, Pepe does love to go here. He follows me like a shadow.
Me and my shadow.
What was that song? Oh, Me and My Arrow. I used to love that
me
little cartoon
me
movie that went...
Me and My Arrow.
Yeah, I love that. The little cartoon that went with it.
Yeah, that was pretty fabulous.
I haven't seen that in years.
That was the same guy that did Live in the Coconut.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
And, crap. What's his name? Oh, no. It is late.
It is late. But, I haven't seen that cartoon in so many years. Yeah, I don't know. I just like that song. It's a fun song. And the cartoon's really cool, too. I don't think as many people know about the cartoon.
So now I'm writing about how much I love Ray Bradbury, which... Yeah.
Well, Ray Bradbury's pretty great.
Ray Bradbury is awesome!
I must say, hey, Ray. Bradberry. That's my favorite flavor of berries.
Bradberries?
Yeah.
I don't think that's a flavor.
Well,
you're making that up.
Whatever. I'm just trying to be.
Harry Nielsen. That's the person.
False half awful cows. I don't know. I like this. And then there's that song always reminded me of Me and You and a Dog Named Boo.
Me and You and a Dog Named Boo.
It's a dumb name. It's not a ghost. And even a ghost isn't stupid enough. It's like, that's just a thing a ghost says.
Boo?
Yeah, ghosts say...
I've never heard a ghost say boo.
I mean, I wouldn't either. It's like the stereotype. But, like, you know, I'm sure a ghost probably said it eventually. I mean, a stereotype comes from somewhere. But... it's stupid. It's like... I don't know, whatever. Anyway, new Cyberpeta. If you want to listen to that, go listen to it over on Captain Creek Records. Unsalted Volume 2. The last Unsalted came out over 5 years ago, and it's the unedited version of the second Cyber Peanut album, Old Man Nevin Shed, but the Unsalted version has an unreleased track, it's got unaltered tracks, got brand new artwork. Go check it out, it's really fun. Also, Chip the Black Boy album coming out soon, too, so look out for that. It's gonna be fun. If you like electronic rap with David Liebehart. Salami.
So now I'm writing a message how I had this, I found it at the thrift store, this Martian Chronicles by Ray Bradbury, and it was, like, illustrated with these, like, cool illustrations, and it was amazing, and then some asshole stole it, and I went on eBay to buy it, and apparently it's collectible.
Oh, no, how much was it?
It was a lot. It was, like, hundreds of dollars.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's annoying.
It was really annoying because it's so cool.
Why didn't you get it?
Because I'm not going to spend hundreds of dollars to buy a book.
No,
that
I mean the one
I,
at the thrift store.
No, I got it from the thrift store and then I had it in my house.
Oh, somebody stole it from you.
Stole it from me, yes.
I thought you meant they stole it from the thrift store.
No, they stole it from me.
Oh.
Sorry.
Oh.
Yeah, they stole
Sweet it. Sweet Fairy Wine.
Damn jerks. There was also like a Martian Chronicles made in the late 70s or early 80s or something.
Yeah, I know about that one.
I guess it's real bad. I remember watching it as a kid and thinking it was great because I loved Ray Bradbury. And
I remember
I loved
liking
sci-fi,
it. I don't remember
so,
anything else about it.
Yeah, I was it's good. It's Ray Bradbury. It's sci-fi. I don't care what anything else.
I didn't know
else.
Anybody thought it was bad, but to be fair, I don't really remember it.
That's all.
Every
that's
time
all
you
I
say
need.
That, it makes me think of the Marcia Chronicles, like Marcia from the Brady Bunch.
Not as good.
Jan?
Not as good.
What had happened? Her foot, the football? My nose!
Yeah. Oh, man. The Brady Bunch is, like, it's still on some of those TV stations on the over-the-air digital, but I just, I mean, the clothes are fun. That's about it.
Oh, come
though.
On. Cousin Oliver?
Oh, everybody, that was the death. That was the death of the Brady Bunch, Cousin Oliver.
Pepe's
poor
over there.
He must have been really.
Yeah, like, I've seen Cousin Oliver now. He's very. He says he just got bullied for his entire life.
I
over
bet. It. That's terrible. Poor guy. As if the Brady Bunch was high art and he ruined it. What the. What the. That's all
the
I got
Brady
to say.
Bunch.
The Brady Bunch. Yeah.
The Brady Bunch is like peak stupid TV. Like
peak stupid? Well, I don't know. That's a pretty. That's it.
Well, yeah, there's dumber TV shows.
Yeah, there's a lot. Remember there was a talking horse show.
Oh, well, come on. Mr. Ed's cool. Tiny Tim does the Mr. Ed theme song.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Not the actual one, but he covered it once.
Oh, okay. All right. Well.
I don't know. I just like Mr. Ed because it's so dumb. I mean, come on. Mr. Ed had a crossover with the pig from my favorite show, Green Acres.
See?
Arnold.
See? The Brady Bunch has got some stiff competition.
Now, to be fair, Mr. Ed is actually stupid, but I kind of like it because it's so dumb. But I actually love the Green Acres. That's probably my favorite TV show. It's so
my
funny.
My family loved Green Acres, but I did not like it. I did not find it funny.
Really?
And I think you also like the Munsters.
The Munsters isn't as good as the Acres, though.
No, you like
the Beverly Hillbillies and Green Acres are my two favorite TV shows by far. At least as far as comedy, like it's like live action comedy.
So you're pro Munster is not Adam's Family, right?
I like the Addams Family, but the Addams Family isn't funny. It's just like stuff happens.
Oh, okay. All right.
The Munsters is like funny, but it's stupid funny. Like, it's just like, you know, just silly voices and stuff. But like, I don't see how anybody thinks the Addams Family is funny. Like, it's watchable, it's entertaining, but it's not funny.
I like the head Munster there, Mr. Big Munster, whatever.
Whatever. Yeah,
Daddy Munster.
Yeah, he's the best one.
Well, he did lots of voice work in old-time radio and stuff,
oh,
and I
good.
Always recognize his voice whenever I'm
Herman.
Listening to old-time... Yeah, that's Herman Munster. Whenever I'm listening to old-time sci-fi, I'm like, oh my god, that's the Munster guy!
Well, you ever see those grandpa reviews of, like, Grandpa Munster reviewing horror movies in the 80s?
Well, he was a pretty cool guy, actually.
Yeah, he was, if you know about his whole history and
yeah,
politics and stuff.
Yeah, May had watched... she watched a documentary on him, and she had said how moving it was. So.
Yeah, Pep's just getting some love. But yeah, he's a really cool guy. I always like Eddie Monster too. I just like the name Eddie. Eddie Herman. I wish people were still named stuff like Eddie and Herman.
Eddie and Herman.
Those are just such great names. Like, people's names now are so dumb. It's like Trevor. What's going on, Trenton? Brandley. It's like
Brandley?
whatever happened to just like Herman or Steve?
You made that
or,
up, Brandley. Brandley.
Like. Uh-oh. Girls' names aren't as bad.
Is he bad? Is he getting poop? Stay out of the kitty poop.
Yeah, Pep likes poop. But, I mean, girls' names haven't suffered as bad, but I think boys' names, like Trentley.
Girls' names get these big clumps, you know, like, you know, just these clumps of names where everybody's an Ashley for a while, and then everybody's, you know, yeah.
That's true. Your name, I think I've seen only, like, 17 people born last year have your name.
Yeah, my name's not so common.
I don't know. I just don't like all these. Hey, what's up, Brandon? What's going on? It's like, ugh.
There's some I'd like to ridicule, but I cannot. It's too mean to ridicule people's names that are just like, what was your, you know?
Trenston. What's going on?
It's such a bro name.
Yeah, all these bro names. It's like, whatever happened to a good, just like, Eddie. It's like, come on. Like a nice Leslie. That's a good boy's name.
Leslie Nielsen was a delightful actor and very funny.
Yeah, I just found out that the guy who killed James Garfield was in this crazy cult where, like, everybody could...
Wait, where'd that come from?
I was just thinking about it. Like, he was in this weird cult where, like, everybody could have sex, but only girls could orgasm because the whole point was, like, eugenics and like, you had to get specific permission. So, like, they would train young boys to not orgasm
what
while having sex.
What cult is this? Wait, whose cult? I'm looking this up.
They would train young boys. They would
cult?
Look up the guy who killed James Garfield. I forget the name of the cult. The Oneida something. But, like, basically, like, they would get, like, older ladies to have sex with young boys. So they would train them not to nut while having sex. So, like, they'd have, like, 12-year-old boys.
You're making this up.
No, I swear to God.
Okay. All right. I'm looking right now.
It's the Oneida something. And, like, the whole thing was, like, it was free love. But you can't orgasm unless you're a girl, unless you get the permission of, like, certain eugenicists in the thing. I mean, I guess girls can't nut, but you know what I'm saying? You can't... And then, like... But, like, they would have, like, these older ladies train young boys not to orgasm so that, like, they would know how to. I forget that... It was the Oneida something. And, they were, it?
Well, no, I'm just reading, you know, gory details.
Yeah, but I just remember thinking that was really weird, because, like, he was in that cult, but he got mad because no one wanted to have sex with him, even though the whole point was free sex and everybody has sex with each other, so he left, and he tried to sue them, but then he just came back anyway.
Let's see. It doesn't say anything in the Wikipedia
and
so
it says,
far. Oh, there we go, the Oneida community.
Yeah, yeah. And when he died, like, he was in court, and he was, like, singing this weird falsetto voice. Like, he was real weird.
Yeah, group marriage aspects of the sect. They rejected him during his 5 years stay there.
Yeah, they called him, like, Get Out or something.
Yeah, they did. They called him Get Out. Oh, wow.
It's just really funny.
Well, history things that you never knew.
Yeah, weird sex cults that, like, the guy who killed Chester Arthur or James Garfield. And he basically killed James Garfield because he wouldn't give him a job and he was pissed.
Yes, he wanted to be in public office.
Come on, just give me a job. No, get out of here. Please, come on. I swear to God, I'll shoot you. Shut up.
Yeah, it's very strange, but... Yeah, those people were also famous for making tons of silverware. Lots and lots of old people still tend to have that silverware. Like, it's a very
common... Oh, no, are you kidding? Those are the people that made the silverware?
Yeah.
We have that silverware. There's probably some downstairs that came from my parents' house.
Oh, really?
There's sex cult silverware downstairs in the kitchen.
Yeah, they didn't...
Eat up!
They didn't make them stop doing it until, like, kind of recently because, like, of all the underage sex with boys.
Pretty wild. I had no idea.
And, like, yeah, I think that they still kind of do exist, but they just kind of, like... You know, I think they just make their silverware now. But I know it was some kind of weird sex cult that made silverware...
Damn it, Wikipedia.
I find it just very amusing, like...
Well, you know, I grew up near the place where they made the monk's bread, and I remember my parents said that's where they make the monk's bread, and I thought they were just screwing with me.
It's cool in there,
but
if you ever see it.
But they actually do make the monk's bread there.
It's very cool inside, if you've never seen it. It's very old-fashioned looking.
I saw it when I was itsy, itsy, itsy bitsy. Tiny, tiny baby size. Like, I don't remember my sister being there, and she was born when I was 2. So I...
Well, geez. So you were, like, 1?
I don't know. I was little. I remember way back. I remember way back.
I remember some of the earliest memories I have of being around 2. I remember I was 2, and this chipmunk.
Traumatized by chipmunks.
Well, we did because we went to grab our pillows or something, and a bunch of chipmunks ate all our food. And I remember it was a bunch of Kaufman's donuts, which I don't even think exists anymore because we were in the Kaufman's place the
other
day.
Right, and we didn't find Kaufman Bakery. Yeah. Oh, God, so much work for donuts.
But, yeah, I don't know, weird sex cult silverware. That's cool. You had it. You had the silverware.
Yeah, we did. We did have the silverware. It was very collectible. It says it's in Ohio now. Unless this is a different Kaufman's.
So it does still exist. Oh, the Kaufman's.
Let me put the Buffalo one on here.
But, yeah, I don't know what made me think of that earlier, but I just wanted to know about the guy who killed James Garfield, and I didn't know it was going to be such a crazy story.
It's gone. It's gone in 2004.
Wow, that's longer ago than I would have thought. I thought I saw it recently, like Kaufman stuff around here.
Apparently not.
I guess not. I mean, I've kind of things that happened like, you know, 15 years ago were like today sometimes. Like I was talking about buying raviolis or something, and my mom was like, that was like in 2005. I'm like, well, I don't know.
I know, I'm always embarrassed when that happens to me as well. I would eat all the breads if I could.
I know.
I can't eat it.
It's no good.
No fair.
I mean, I don't know. I feel like it's unless you get really good bread, it's not even usually worth getting anyway.
It's easy to get really good. I used to love just the Tops used to make their Italian loaves of bread every day.
Well, those are good.
They used to be 3 for $1, and I was poor. And boy, oh boy, that was like what I lived on. That and potatoes and government cheese and rice. We had government rice as well.
Well, I mean, the Tops bread, that's pretty good, I gotta say. I actually like white bread, but like if you get like cheap other bread, I think it's really bad.
When we were kids, we would squish it like the, you know, like the Wonder Bread. We'd squish it. So we didn't have Wonder Bread. We had like whatever was the generic version. And we'd squish it back into a ball and say we made it back into dough.
Oh, I actually did that too.
Yeah, my mom would be like, you eat that.
That was always
like, okay, we're eating dough, Mom.
My breakfast as a kid, we would just get white bread and put it in milk. That was our cereal.
Oh. We would toast it, and then there was someone who kept a beehive on our property, so he gave us free honey. So we would toast it and put butter and honey on it because we had so much free honey that it would crystallize before we could eat it all.
I love crystallize. I love when the honey gets kind of hard, though. It's so good when it's like you just kind of scoop up.
It's hard to eat the honey from stores because it tastes like garbage because most of it is garbage.
It is, unless you get like real honey, which is hard to find.
It is hard to find.
I know, people don't even know that the honey they're eating is garbage. I just saw a whole video on that, too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
People do. I mean, it's like... I used to... One time I bought this pair of headphones from this dollar store in the mall downtown, and I remember it lasted the bus ride home, and then it literally, I pulled it out, and they fell apart. But inside that store, they had the grossest-looking fake honey ever. It was like... It said it was like 60% like corn syrup. It's like, that's so gross. It didn't even look like edible. It's so disgusting.
Which dollar store was it?
I don't know.
How long ago was it?
Oh gosh, this was definitely over 10 years ago.
Okay, it's hard to say then. There was still more than one in there, I believe, at that point.
Yeah, I don't. I just wanted headphones because like I hated waiting for the bus forever downtown. And you know, those ones that literally only read. As soon as I pulled them out, they literally fell. They were made out of rope.
Oh, I have some like that.
It was just weird.
Those are usually a little... They don't tangle up as bad.
All I know is these cost 50 cents, and they...
High fidelity?
And it was very... I saved them just because of how amazingly cheap they look. It just looked like somebody took like an old piece of rope and shoved some wiring through it. Oh. The dollar store was the cheapest, most disgusting stuff I've ever seen.
Is it still there?
I don't know. I haven't been to that mall in so long.
There's not much there. There's a good coffee shop, and there's good pizza, which, of course, I can no longer freaking eat.
I like the food there. They
have
a good food
court.
There was a
Payless, but all the Paylesses went out of business.
That was one of the last places I went to. There was the Payless. And also, there was a mini...
Oh, there's another shoe place that is not a Payless. It's just an independent shoe place.
What's it called? I don't remember that.
I think it's called Steppin.
Oh, They had a Borders there, but I don't think Borders is around.
Oh, no, that's long gone. I remember when that was there. I used to work downtown, so I would go there to that mall. And also, catching the bus downtown to Batavia, I'd sometimes get food there or whatever.
They do have good food in them.
Yeah.
I think. Plus, Gina and Joe's I really liked.
Yeah, that's a good pizza.
But now I like Pharaoh's. That's my new favorite. I want to try their gluten-free pizza because Pharaoh's is like some of my favorite pizza.
I still have to try it.
Michelle, it's very... Work
out that vaccine, damn it. I will totally take that vaccine.
I like gluten-free pizza now, though. It's now... My favorite pizza is that gluten-free pizza in Batavia.
You mean Geneseo.
Isn't that... Oh, no, you're right. That's...
Jeez, John, you think all the small country towns look alike?
Well, that one doesn't really at all.
You
that one
say
just...
yes.
A lot of them do, but that one doesn't.
Geneseo or Batavia?
Geneseo.
Oh, okay. Because
right. Geneseo is just kind of like, I don't know, it's a little more happening.
Well, they got the State University of New York at Geneseo, right downtown.
That's true. But Batavia is even more so. Like, Batavia doesn't even seem like a small town to me. It's like a medium town.
People in Batavia would be happy to hear that.
I mean, it's like...
It has really great... It has some great restaurants there, which
yeah,
is
it does.
Quite delightful.
Like, I really like Batavia a lot. Like, I think Batavia's really nice.
Hmm. Let's not get crazy, but...
Well, I like it. I mean, it just seems so calming there.
Yeah, there is good food there. That's true. There's very good food.
I think one of the weirdest tiny towns I was at was, Oh, no.
Oh, no.
That happened at these
exact I just realized my sneakers are coming apart and whatever.
That happened to these shoes
until
I glued them back on.
Yeah, I got shoe goo, but... I mean, I bought them a long time ago. I shouldn't complain. I mean, I bought them, like, a real long time ago.
Sneakers are just so ugly, but that's sad.
They are ugly.
I don't like sneakers.
I don't know how old these are. That's so...
That's...
Totally. I don't know if people can see in the TV world. There my fingers go right in.
They look like Skechers.
They're Asics.
Asics.
Gel Platinum.
I don't even know what that is.
Yeah. I was going to say, one of those sneaker breeds.
I only like Clarks or those sandals. I like those sandals. But I can't wear cheap shoes. My feet hurt so bad I can't even walk.
Those weren't cheap shoes. Those were like, I don't know, $70 or
no, something. I'm just saying, like, I can't wear, like, it literally hurts. Like, I have such flat feet that I can't walk for more than, like, I can't walk hardly at all without really good shoes.
That stinks.
It's really annoying.
Yeah, I was noticing when I was running, I was like, why does it seem like it's so kind of tricky running? I feel like I'm going to fall. Oh, because my shoes are... Sole of my shoe is totally off. That's why. Damn it.
That's all.
Also, I got big feet, so it's a little trickier. I can't really find things. I mean, I could probably just find men's sneakers. That doesn't really matter.
Yeah, a shoe is a shoe.
I've got some even older pairs. Like, that's my newest pair, though. I mean, shoes and sneakers all kind of look the same to me, so...
They all do look the same. They're all the same ugly thing.
Yeah, one morning I went to the gym, and I put my sneakers on, and I went up to the gym. People were looking at me funny, and I was like, what's everybody looking at me funny for? And I go downstairs, and I put two different sneakers on. I went up to the gym. Because they all look so similar.
Well, yeah, whatever. Who cares?
Yeah. It happens. It was real embarrassing.
Yeah. I know this. Oh, never mind.
It's almost. Wait, the countdown. The countdown is coming.
Yeah, I was going to tell a real intense story, but
don't
that doesn't
tell
need to be said
story.
Now.
Save it. Save it for later. Yes, do that. Save it for later.
All I'm saying. Yeah, never mind. I probably should never even tell that story.
Call or text us and tell us about your sneaker stories or your beloved pet stories or any other stories you feel like passing on to